All right, guys. I hope you are back. We are basically covering the very important questions. Give me one second. We are covering the 41 important question of Postman, and right now we are at 22nd. And let's jump into it directly because this is important video, guys, and we have to learn. And these are the important questions generally people ask you about from API testing and Postman. Okay. So the next question is basically, which is how to add headers in Postman. And sometimes people ask this question, how do you add headers and what are headers actually? So if you jump into the Postman directly, go to this header tab, right? Headers are nothing but a key value pair where you send your meta information to the server. For example, you will send them a user agent. You're basically telling them it's a Postman client. So server will know that, okay, this is a Postman client that want to work with me. Okay, you can send them, okay, I have a content type, I'm basically sending you a JSON request, because right in the body, so that's what we are telling them in the header. So you, all the information, all the important information, you can say that, and it is not visible to anyone, are sent to the headers. Okay, and other important things are sent via body. Okay, head body. So body is basically sent for any logic and other things. If you sending head, it basically means meta information key value pair related to your user agent, your acceptance, your content type, your content length, any connections, keep alive or host, like this kind of informations. Okay. What is a content type? People ask you this question, right? What exactly is a content type? Content type basically telling the server that what type of request, in which format you are sending. So you can mention that I'm sending an application JSON, right? Here also, for example, let me add another. If you type content type here, if you see, I can select XML, I can select JSON, JavaScript, OGG. OGG is a kind of, I think, MP, audio file, PDF, PostScript, XML, RSS, SOAP, and anything I can say, I can basically select here, right? So it's up to the server, like how they want to add it. So if I selected this, I think it's automatically cut, right? There's a duplicate header, it's telling you point. Right. That's how you add it. Content type basically means telling the server that what type of content we are sending. We are sending application JSON, XML, any audio file, any image, just telling them in the to the server. How do I add cookie? I think this is probably the simplest way. You can do it by using this cookie. Click on it, add, and here, add, just type the domain name, for example, vw.com, right? And here you can add the cookie. So cookies are again key value pair. Here is a key, you can say login cookie, and the value is allowed, something like this. Okay, this is not a valid device, it was just, I'm telling you, it's again a key value pair. See, path is key value are expiry date. There's a particular expiry date also, and you do a save, it will be automatically added. So if you do a send request, right, you will see it will be automatically added to the request. So sometimes what happens is some of the authorization are with the cookies. So you send a username password, they will send you a cookie, and every time now you will make a new request, you have to send the cookie rather than sending the username password every time. Okay, that's how sometimes authentication works and for some of the websites, especially with the UW.com. Okay, what is Workspace? Workspace, I think, it basically allow you to have a sandbox kind of environment. Right now, I'm this workspace where suppose I'm working with staging servers, right? Staging.builder.ai, something like this. If I want to switch to another one, I can create new and let's call it product, production. And you can basically add more people into the workspace so that they can also have access to this collection that you are creating. So now I am at a production. Now I have a different set of collections rather than the traditional my testing academy, right? So this is the way. Workspaces are nothing but a sandbox environment for keeping the request different in a simple way. Collection is nothing but a collection of it's a collection of request, right? For example, I have this collection which contains further collections, right? So basic auth, something like this, right? So this is a basic auth example. And here we have added the basic auth admin. It will automatically add it to the authorization if you see, and authentication true, we are getting a response. How do you monitor the collection? It's very simple. You can basically click on this and add a monitor collection. Monitoring a collection basically means at a particular interval you want to check the response. Okay, so suppose I have a particular API. For example, it will basically open the scrolltest.com, my own website. Definitely give it a try. For it's very good for automation learning. Go to scrolltest.com and just check if everything works fine. 200, okay. I want to check that. I can create a collection and add it to this where I'll weekly every day 2 p.m. I want to test it out if it is working fine or not. So that's what exactly is monitoring. Like we have in monitor, right? To monitor a particular API at particular intervals, right? So that's what we are doing in monitoring. Mocking of API, it's nothing but, for example, your APIs are there. I mean, you have a particular API, you don't know the endpoint as of now. So developer is creating that API and it will give you a response. That response is something like very similar to this. So let me cancel that, click on this. So it will say that, okay, this is the response. So what I can do is that if this is known, I can create a mock server in Postman, which will basically return this thing every time. And it will give you a dummy URL. Whenever you hit that dummy URL, it will always give you this response. And you can write your test cases according to it right now. For example, I can check my 200, okay. I can check my JSON value, right? So JSON value user should be admin, right? If you do it, let's run the test. If you see everything is passing, right? It basically means I can do a mocking. How you can do it? It's very simple. Go to this, go to the three dots, create a mock collection, right? And you can say lol, I mean, not lol, yeah. It's a Postman Q&A. Right. If you want to select a tag or if you want to select any environment variable, we are not doing it. Create a mock server. It will give you a URL. Right. And here, right, if you do a particular request, it will give you a response. I mean, let me show you again. Okay. So let's do a raffle. Let's create a test collection. So in test collection, let's do one thing. Let's have. So we don't know the request as of now, we know the response only. So what we'll do is that we'll basically do a monitor. We'll do a mock collection. Again, test. Create a mock collection, right? And it will do it for us, okay? Now, if you hit it, it will basically reply you back. Now, what you can do is that in another video of API testing using Postman, I have basically created number of most mock collection that you can do give it a try. Okay, so let's do one thing. How do you export a Postman request? So you can export it by using click this icon, and here you will have an export option. You can do it in 2.1, 2, and 1. I'll highly rec use. You should use a recommended one. That's actually important. Okay. How do I add a test cases in Postman? I think this is the easiest one. Just open any request, click on the test icon, and here you can find some pre-built test cases like 200. Okay, just give it a send request. Suppose I want to check page is equal to 2, so I'll say page. It should be 2, right? So this is my test one. This is test 2, and you can basically check that, right? So both of them are passing. So more extensive, more everything related to API is in API testing using Postman. You can give it a try, guys. All right, let me show you the playlist if you are interested. Testing, my testing academy. Go to the testing academy, guys. Go to the testing academy, go to playlist, and you will see here 30 days. Here is a Postman API testing using Postman. Everything is there. You can check it out. Okay. All the tutorials. Awesome. Awesome. What is prescript and postscript? I think this is the easiest example. Prescript is basically where you want to, if you want to run your code before. Right, it's before, guys. Right, so prescript you will see here, it will run before this request, And test basically runs after this request. So that's the only reason. In pre-request, what you can do is you can generate some variable. For example, if you have a particular API where you want to fill some data, right? For example, it can be a username, password, and all. You can generate your variables here and basically set them and append it to the body. And after that, you can test them and test back in the test cases. Make sense? Pre and post. Right. How do I send binary, hexagonal binary, or this thing? I think this is important. Go to body tab. Here you can send form data. You can send form data with URL encoded raw file. If you want to send raw file, for example, da. Sometimes this is supported. You can change them to JSON, and you can send a binary file, which is basically file upload. You can do a GraphQL testing also. Here you can write your GraphQL queries, and if you have any variable, you can test them also. Yeah. Again, GraphQL works when you have a post request most of the time. Awesome. How to use GraphQL? Easiest way is, guys, similar to post request with the values. And let me do one thing. Yeah, if you do a GraphQL, then you will see a GraphQL tutorial also. GraphQL. Yeah, you will see a 2-3 GraphQL tutorials where I have discussed extensively what exactly is GraphQL and how to use it. Okay. Awesome. Let's jump back to my node. Yeah. Awesome. I think this is already covered. What is environment variable? It is basically a set of key value pairs, which basically help you to switch to a particular environment. You can have a staging environment, you can have a production environment. If you want to switch them, you can do it by using environment variables. It's nothing but a key value pair JSON file in Postman. What are the different type of variables which is important? We have local variable, global variable, that collection level, and data variable. Local is when you create it here. So in the test, if you create any kind of a variable, right, it's a local variable. For example, where a is equal to 10, it's a local variable, guys. And if you are running as a data-driven testing, have you done it? Probably you have seen my video of API testing Postman, in which we are doing it. That's a data level or iteration level. Collection level, you can add it here. Go to your collection, click, go to your collection, and give me 1 second. Minus two, edit, right? Here you can add your variables also. So those will become the collection level and global, or of course we have global and environment also, guys. I think that's missing, which is environment, env, environment variable also. All of them are discussed in the other videos. Not gonna discuss right now. How do we stop executing request and stop the collection run? I think which is you can do that by using this postman.nextRequest null. Just check out the API chaining video where I have discussed extensively how to use this. And this is important thing. Some people are asking this kind of question, where how do I basically stop the execution if there's a particular thing I want it while running the collection. You can use postman.nextRequest. Suppose if they are asking, I want to do API chaining, and where if response is ID is not null, then I want to do this and this. You can do use this function again. Instead of null, you have to just type the collection request name. Okay. Awesome. What are some libraries available in Postman? I think this is very important. Chai.js is available. It basically means assert and expected. All the assertion related to it are there present. You can get moment.js, which basically used for date time, Lodash for couple of utilities like for each loop and other array manipulation, GUID again to generate GUIDs. Okay, Postman console. I think sometimes people confused with it, and sometimes they don't know. Click on view, you'll see a Postman console. It is basically used to debug or see your variables output. If you want to see, everything will be logged in the Postman console. It takes time to load it, but see, whatever the request that we have made, you can check the results here. Everything in the console. Awesome. How do I add proxy? It's very simple. Just go here, this same icon, add your proxies here. Okay. You can use interceptor also, and you can add cookies also, global cookies if you want. How do I enable the SSL verification? Sometimes what happens is you have a local API where SSL is not added. You can go to settings and enable and disable the SSL if you want. Okay. What is a collection runner? Collection runner is nothing but which will help you to run your collection. For example, I can run this. Suppose this one I have created, right? I can run this collection. If you click on run, it will start executing it, and it can run multiple requests one by one. If you can add logic also by using the postman dot second request that I have told you, right? So you can do that. If you select it, you can just there's no request. That's why if you select it, you can run them directly, and it will start executing one by one all the requests. Okay, we don't want it. You can stop it. You can export the results also. Retry. You can see fail and pass count and results. Everything is there. All right. So that was it, guys. That was the 41 important question that I think. And if I have missed anything, guys, make sure you are you let me know. Let me know in the comments, because these are important, guys. And postman and repeat testing related questions generally asked by interviewer, right? And I hope this is helpful, guys. If this is helpful, please make sure to like and subscribe and share this video with your friends and all. I'll see you in the next video, where we'll be covering the more advanced question related to postman or repeat testing in the next video. All right. Thanks a lot. If you like, thanks a lot. This is your host Pramod, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye.